Hey all, welcome to Design and Presentation channel. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe to receive a notification whenever a new video is uploaded. In this tutorial, I am going to show how to make this line chart animation in Microsoft PowerPoint. This video is broken down into three main parts. First, I'll be designing the core portion of this slide, that is the chart. Next, I'll be working on the labels and other minor design accessories to the chart. Lastly, I'll be showing how to provide animation effects to finalize the design. Now let us get on with this tutorial. To begin with, open a new slide. First, change the background color of the slide from Design tab. Choose Gradient Fill option. Delete the second and third gradient stop markers. Then use the eyedropper tool to pick up the colors for the start and end gradient stops. Next, insert a rounded corner rectangle on the slide from the shapes library. Click and drag the orange dot towards the right to make the corners more rounded. Then, change the dimensions and color of the shape. After that, keeping the shape selected, hold down the Shift and Control keys and drag your mouse to the right to duplicate the shape on the same horizontal level. Repeat this step two more times. After dragging, first remove your click from the mouse and then stop pressing down the Shift and Control keys. Now select all these rectangles and group them together by pressing Ctrl G and apply the center alignment effect on it. Then put these rectangles out of the group formation. Next, place an oval shape on the slide. Change the fill and outline color and edit its dimensions to make it a circle. Place it on top of the connecting points of the first and its adjoining rectangle. Again, hold down the Shift and Control keys and drag your mouse to the right to duplicate the circle on the same level. After that, make a copy of your first slide. In the second slide, change the fill and outline color and reduce the dimensions of the connecting circles. Next, reduce the height of the rectangles from 0.1 inch to 0.08 inch. Now provide a shadow effect on all these elements. You can skip reformatting these in your slide. This is an extra step to make the design look better. Now I am going to insert a line chart, and by referring to this chart, I'll be designing our final graph. I am going to put in sample data here. After you have entered your data, close the data editor window. Then, resize the chart so that the graph points are more or less on the same vertical line with the connector circles that we have on our slide. Pull up the chart and send it backwards so that we can put our lines on top of this. Using the same Shift, Ctrl and mouse drag drill, create copies to place the connector circles. Now, drag the rectangles and place them on top of these lines. I am keeping our line chart open-ended. Feel free to modify the ends as per your data. Our line chart sketch is now ready. Remove the reference chart from behind and also the connector circles. Next, go to the Transitions tab and apply Morph Transition effect on this slide. Upon applying, you can see how the horizontal line is moving seamlessly to create and give shape to our line chart. This is the main idea behind this design. Moving on to the second portion of this tutorial, I will be now creating the labels, title, and also do minor changes to our chart. In the first slide, duplicate the leftmost rectangle by pressing Ctrl D and change its color and dimensions. Next, enter the label inside and change its font. Create copies of this on the same level in similar fashion. Now, I will create the heading and subtitle of the slide. Using the alignment tool, keep these in the center. Now copy paste the title, subtitle and the labels onto the second slide. Next, I'll be creating the data points. I'm copying the x-axis label and modifying it to design the data point. Next, insert a triangle onto the slide and flip it vertically. Change its color to match with that of the data point. Place it on the bottom of the data point and send it to the back. Now, group them together by pressing Ctrl G to make it look like a speech bubble. You can also use an inbuilt speech bubble from the Shapes library. Create the other data points in similar fashion. Now I am going to beautify this chart by adding icon against each data point. You can use your own icon which you find relevant for your chart. The next step is to make the icon sizes proportional to the data points such that they indicate a visual story to your audience. As an example here, for the data points 200, 300 and 250 and keeping the corresponding icon dimensions to 2, 3 and 2.5 inches. you can reposition the chart area if needed. Next, I will depict the percentage changes between the adjacent data points to emphasize the trend. The green color is for indicating a positive change in the data point, and the red color is for signifying a downfall. Coming to the last portion of this tutorial, I'll be adding some animations. First, apply zoom in animation effect to the icons. Then add wipe animation effect to the data points. For now, set all these animations to appear simultaneously. I'll be editing them later on. Next, apply the zoom in animation to the percentage change indicator circles and wipe effect to the corresponding figure. Now, I am going to shuffle some of these animations and also edit their triggering points. Enter into slideshow mode to view the final animated line chart. You can download the template for free from the Google Drive link provided in the video description below. I have also included an icon-free version of the slide in that PowerPoint. Do let me know in the comments if you wish to have any particular template designed out for you. If you want to view more designs and tutorials like this, please subscribe to this channel. You can also check out other line chart designs by clicking on these thumbnails. Thank you.